right now. That's the last name that has some significance in the Southland Conference. We'll have more on that in just a bit. The opening tip controlled by the Lumberjacks, whose pursuit of a tournament title begins today. Kerry Sitton, Toby Martinez, and Jabe Durham, the familiar names who will be our officiating crew here today.
Well, look for both these ball clubs to play tough half-court man-to-man defense. Stephen F. Austin, known as one of the premier defensive teams in the country. How about Walkup? They clear the side on the first possession, and he gets the easy kiss off the glass. Good execution.
Thomas Walkup is coming off a career-high 38 points in Huntsville this past Saturday. SFA finished their year on a three-game road trip. Their last home game was February 27th against these Huskies. Wide open is Charles in the corner, too strong. An offensive rebound, something that everybody wearing the purple and white does so well pursuing the loose ball.
Well, Holyfield went a long way to get that one. Good hands in the retrieval.
10 to shoot, here's Holyfield. That's within his range. A 40% three-point shooter from beyond the arc. Third time the charm for SFA. Meech Floyd, second-team All-Conference, drills it.
Well, Demetrius Floyd is an outstanding talent. Can drill the long ball or take it tough on the hardwood.
And the ball is going to stay on this end of the floor moments later. Well, SFA, a fantastic crowd that reaches all the way up to the back row. Now, mind you, the women of Stephen F. Austin were on this floor moments ago, falling in an upset to Sam Houston State. So the folks from Nacogdoches able to stick around. TJ Holyfield.
Good quick release by Holyfield. That three we saw him take on the earlier possession was a rarity. He had only attempted 35 threes during the course of the season in 30 ball games.
TJ's older brother Michael spent 4 years with Sam Houston State as their near 7-foot post presence. Last year's Defensive Player of the Year in the league.
Nice job by Duncey breaking hard to the bucket then. Moving without the basketball. He had gone hard and off the dribble earlier, but the good SFA defense stymied that attempt.
As Duncey, they'll throw it into the backcourt. Guarded by Pinckney.
Yeah, guarded is a good word. He is one of the best defenders in this league. Pinckney will get right up in there with you.
Holyfield with the help. Thomas Walkup with the blocked shot. Fired up ahead. Well, it's a 9-0 start for the two-time defending champions. Make it three-time regular season champs coming into this year.
Lincoln defense made that possible. Great team rotation. Thomas Walkup, first team all-conference defensively, gets the block, and they're off to the races. Terrific job. Watch this job. Coming across the paint, Walkup gets the block. Get it out to Pinckney. He gets the ball up the floor quickly to Demetrius Floyd. Nice execution by the number one team in the conference.
Sam Houston State has won the last two tournament titles. Looking for three in a row. They have won the last four regular season championships in the Southland Conference. All of them outright. They became the first ever Southland men's basketball program to win four straight outright.
I think it was interesting yesterday when we were talking to Brad Underwood. They've won the league three times in a row, but he said this is the best of the three teams he's had. Primarily, he thinks that because they're the best defensive team he's coached. And they average almost 80 points per game.
Huskies trying to get on the board.
You can't ever relax against this SFA defense.
Straightaway stroke is good. About a half hour from the HBU campus as that one ultimately falls for Caleb Creighton.
Well, Creighton hit two yesterday. Good start for him today. That should be a confidence builder indeed.
And Meech Floyd trying to find his second three-pointer of the ball game. Again, another offensive rebound here early on for SFA.
This SFA team is not bashful about taking the three-point shot. Well, look at there. Holyfield jumps out. I just said he had only taken 35 the whole year. But if they're going to drop off of him, he's going to take it to the attempt.
They are giving Holyfield a three-pointer. His toe may have been on the line. We already have James Durham asking to review that at the next stoppage in play, but at the moment it's 12-3. They could very well take a point away from SFA upon review in a little while.
Yeah, it really did look like his toe was on the line, but it may be the angle at which we sit. Caleb Creighton That was all 3 points, all four now for the Huskies.
62% free throw shooter. Young man from Oklahoma City in his final campaign with HBU. It's a Huskies team. Their first year in the Southland Conference 2 years ago finished 13th outside the hunt for the tournament. Last year they were tied for the final seed but were ineligible. So HBU made their debut officially yesterday with a victory over Southeastern Louisiana. What I'm trying to tell you is HBU has never lost in the Southland Conference tournament. They'd like to keep that going. Thomas Walkup just doing what he does.
Well, but he just attacked Isaiah Robinson, who's tops in the league and blocked shots, blocked four shots yesterday. Walkup just shielded him with his body, knows how to play the game.
Yeah, Robinson had a nice outing yesterday. He's seen significant minutes as a true freshman, in part because Josh Ibarra, the lone true veteran post presence for HBU, is out presumably for the rest of the season with a foot injury, and there is Robinson on cue.
Yeah, that's a real loss for the Huskies not having Ibarra. He had the best field goal percentage shooting in the league this year.
Holyfield, we'll see him play in the post defensively and offensively, but Brad Underwood is thrilled with what the young freshman can do with his range. As the rebound comes down to Coulter Lasher.
Well, that was a nice block out by Lasher all the way from Anchorage, Alaska.
Odunsi goes into the body of Charles. Pinckney with the rebound, leading the charge up ahead to Floyd.
A good court awareness by Floyd. Let your teammates get down there, get settled. There was nobody there for the rebound if he had taken the quick shot.
You asked Brad Underwood yesterday how he handled all this time off with the double bye. You wondered if there'd be rust. No signs of it as SFA got off to a 9-0 start in this ballgame.
Well, really is just 6 days off, but that's a long time in a basketball season indeed. But I can tell you, I thought his answer would be, we spent it all working on defense.
Just about 5 minutes into this one, the defending champs doubling up the four seed HBU Huskies 14-7. Was our score going to break. The officials did make their way over to the replay monitor, and TJ Holyfield's toe was just a millimeter off the line. It is a three-pointer for the freshman. It remains a 7-point lead for the number one seed SFN.
Lincoln, only 4 minutes and 45 seconds into this game. Interesting statistic has developed. Stephen F. Austin has 4 offensive rebounds to 0 for Houston Baptist. Here we're going to take a look at exactly what the referees were looking at. You can see it, the millimeter that Lincoln used to describe how far he was behind that line. But he definitely was behind it. Good job by this officiating crew led by Kerry Sitton here today, a longtime veteran in many leagues in the NCAA basketball.
TJ Holyfield, a starter day one as a true freshman on a team like SFA. That tells you how talented he was. In fact, he was their leading scorer in their season opener against Baylor in Waco. Holyfield already 5 points, four rebounds in this ballgame, not even 5 minutes old.
And you mentioned that rebounding total, very important. 4 minutes and 45 seconds into the game, Stephen F. Austin has 12 shots to only five for Houston Baptist. That is because they have four offensive rebounds to zero for Houston Baptist. Yeah. That's how important that one statistic is.
6 second chance points for Stephen F. Austin, almost half of their total early on.
You can see Clyde Giffard in the lineup now for Stephen F. Austin. He's, in my books, one of the best six men in America. He's only started two of their 30 games this year, but he was so highly recognized in his ability that he was picked third team all-conference.
Creighton has 7 of the Huskies' 9 here in the early get-go.
You can see Stephen F. Austin moves the ball so well, keeps the floor balanced, gives their players opportunities to go one-on-one, just as Walkup did there.
Asa Cantwell's in the ballgame. Odunsi's going to take it all the way to the hole.
Well, Odunsi showed his strength and quickness and power right there, taking it in traffic for the kiss off the glass. All of a sudden, we've got a three-point ball game.
I brought up Cantwell. He had 5 three-pointers yesterday in a shootout with Southeastern off the bench for his 15 points.
Well, we had a little double 11 action right there.
Yeah, Creighton getting tied up with Clyde Giffard.
Creighton got called for this foul. Giffard was there in plenty of time to set the pick.
Walkup has Robinson off balance, and that will be a trip to the free throw line for the senior from Deer Park.
Well, what a nice fundamental maneuver he just made to draw that foul. Ball fake, head fake. More of the young players in America would get that ingrained in their mind when they're starting to move. Fake your defender with your head and that ball, and they'll usually leave the floor, and that's what happened there.
Walkup, a 78% free throw shooter coming into today.
Ty Charles coming out, outstanding sophomore. Didn't have quite as good of numbers this year as he had last year as a freshman, but he's an integral part of the future of SFA basketball.
Yeah, only 2 starters remaining on the floor right now, including Walkup, who makes them both. The other one being Clyde Giffard. Up ahead. And the Huskies.
Boy, how about a nice job of breaking that press. Beautiful passing up the floor. Nice finish on that play by Alex Fountain for the Huskies.
The 6'7 Tennessee native playing above the rim.
A nice job of running the floor. Used good speed there against that press.
This is a 3-point ball game.
Robinson should have had that rebound. He just kind of tipped it out, trying to get one of his teammates to get a long ball.
Walkup able to find the angle off the glass.
Well, it's tough to go behind the screen against him. He just knows how to maneuver. Fountain went behind the pick, and he paid the price. Walkup 2 more.
8 points early for Thomas Walkup. And he's coming off a week where he had 38 points against the rival in Huntsville, and earlier that week was in San Antonio with a triple-double. An offensive foul will send it back the other way.
Let's take a look like right quick at this last basket by Walkup. Look at the whole side of the floor is cleared for him. Fountain went behind the pick up at the head of the circle, and Walkup just takes it all the way in for the kiss off the glass. Terrific execution. I love the way they create opportunities, particularly for Walkup, by clearing the side of the floor.
So he takes a seat with those 8 points. Holyfield among those who have come back on the floor for Brad Underwood. And Thomas Walkup, not just your player of the year, but for the past 3 seasons has been on the all-defensive squad of the Southland. And that's an offensive foul against Clyde Giffard.
Well, that was great defense by Caleb Creighton that time. He's playing a heck of a ball game so far here today.
Both teams have been whistled 4 times early on. And a mild pressure from the defense from Stephen F. Austin. Stephen Osuji in the ballgame as your ball handler. Touch foul, Dallas Cameron.
Yeah, that was a little too much pressure out there by Cameron. Of course, that's a new rule of emphasis. Of course, it's not very smart to call it new anymore. Here we are at the end of the season, but those bumps that you used to could get away with, not anymore.
This is the 19th meeting all time between these two programs. Cantwell had 5 3-pointers go through yesterday. 0 for 1 here to start.
Well, Cantwell's never met a 3-point opportunity he didn't like, and he put that one up rather quickly.
SFA leads the all-time series 17-1, including winners of their last 9.
That was a great job by Gafford using that screen to get open. Just missed an easy shot. He usually knocks that one down. Stephen F. Austin leads the league in field goal percentage shooting.
A kick out. This from Fountain. Offensive rebound from Robinson.
Nice job by Robinson kicking it out quickly.
He clears the lane, creates some space. And the beneficiary is Stephen Osuji, the Houston native.
Osuji really showed some quickness there with that first step, beating the SFA defense to the paint.
And a foul away from the basketball will wipe away this bucket from Ty Charles. 18-15. Houston Baptist trying to close what was at one point a 9-0 start for SFA. Semifinals underway here in Katy.
Working with the Houston Astros to pioneer less invasive treatments for shoulder injuries. Advancing the way we treat foot and ankle injuries for Houston Ballet. And using innovative healing techniques to get the Houston Texans back on the field faster. Working with elite athletes to better treat the everyday athlete. That's the difference between practicing medicine and leading it. Houston Methodist, leading medicine.
Lumberjacks make great teachers. Lumberjacks make great engineers, too. And urban foresters, composers, and CEOs. In fact, lumberjacks make great professionals in 120 fields of study. So no matter what you want to become, become an SFA lumberjack first.
I believe my inner child belongs on the outside.
I believe you should never be afraid to speak your mind.
I believe knowledge is free and can be shared with anyone.
I believe if you spend too much time looking back, you'll miss what's ahead, like a wall.
I believe with faith, the future isn't so intimidating.
At HBU, belief isn't just a mindset, it's an action. And our mission is to empower our students so their beliefs can fuel their lives. HBU, a higher education.
Well, yesterday, not only did HBU pick up their first ever victory in the Southland Conference Tournament, Ron Cottrell's 452nd career win with HBU. You take a look at that tenure. For a decade and a half, he was juggling dual responsibilities as both AD and head coach for Houston Baptist. And, well, his daughter's in attendance. As you see, Scotland as well as Sydney Ann. Scotland is the manager for this men's team. Sydney Ann's actually a freshman on Texas A&M Corpus Christi's women's basketball team this year.
A good defense continuing now for Houston Baptist. Forced another less than desirable shot by the Lumberjacks. Got to admire the poise that Houston Baptist has had to come back from that 9-0 deficit. Did not get all shook up.
Both teams have been whistled for 5 fouls here early on. Fountain will hand off to Cantwell.
Oh, good help by Walker.
Charles will poke it loose. Recovered with 10 seconds to shoot. Holyfield leaves his feet. Walker with the weak side rebound.
Well, that was a great move that time by Alex Fountain.
Walker dishes to Holyfield. TJ will be shooting free throws in just a moment.
A transition game so important to SFA's success. Holyfield did a nice job of trailing to make that opportunity possible.
And TJ Holyfield and his brother Michael grew up in Albuquerque, but TJ attended the Elevate Sports Institute over in Florida. where he would land on the radar of this SFA coaching staff.
Good free throw shooter, 71%. In fact, both these ball clubs here today are very good at the free throw line. SFA shoots their free throws at a 72% clip, and Houston Baptist 71. Anytime you're over 70%, that's recognized as very, very good.
And Holyfield gets the job done.
Well, he's got a great future. He's got a nice, nice shot, and he's so determined on the boards. Just a fresh start at all 30 games. That's amazing in a program like this.
But to think with all the success that Stephen F. Austin has had, for them to have a true freshman on day one as a starter, double dribbled the call, ultimately going against HBU's Chukwu Jeku, another Houston native in his own right. But for a true freshman to start day one for Brad Unwood, that had to surprise, I would think, even the head coach.
Well, I think it surprised him, certainly, but that's a pretty good indicator of how good teachers that staff is. When you can teach a freshman to do all the things that this team excels in that quickly.
A 12-footer won't go. Offensive rebound down to Chukwu Jeku.
Michi Floyd normally will make that shot.
Footsteps, forgetting to put the ball on the court, Cody Stetler.
Good quick double team down there on the block by the SFA defense, leading to the shuffling of the feet.
As Osuji gets a breather. He's a reminder of the reason why the city of Houston can have four Division I basketball programs. Of course, we're just on the west side of Houston here in Katy, Texas. So much talent in the area. That's certainly to HBU's advantage in the long run.
SFA, three very small guards all on the floor right now at the same time. Jared Johnson with the basketball there.
Out to Holyfield. Thought better of that shot. He's 1-for-4 from beyond the arc today. With 1 second to go, it was Walkup who had pulled the trigger. Cantwell looking for his first three, has it.
Shouldn't be a surprise when that young man knocks it down. A great three-point pure shooter. Yep. Not such a quick release. That's what makes that possible. SFA was right out there on him. Thought they had him covered, but he has just got that uncanny ability to release it quickly.
He had five of them yesterday in the Southeastern game. The pride of the Alamo City comes through.
Well, Cantwell made five of those last night, and he is, all scouting reports always are going to say, when Cantwell has the basketball and it's a three-point range, he's going to take the shot.
On the other end, the foul was on reveal, Chukwu Jeku. It's the seventh team foul, so the bonus kicks in for the rest of this opening half for SFA.
Well, this little guy at the line for SFA is a terrific defensive player. In fact, he was honored on the All-Southland defensive team this year as one of the top five defenders in the league, and he should certainly be an inspiration to all small guys around the country.
Well, Pinckney, who has one more free throw, is from right here in Katy, attended Seven Lakes High School. Type of three-point play for number three coming up.
Well, that's very, very unusual, and let me tell you why, Lincoln. This is, now listen to this. He's got 52 field goals on the year. 45 of those have been three-pointers. Now he's got 53 field goals on the year, but that's a pretty interesting statistic. Coming into the game, 52 field goals, 45 of those threes.
Hasn't been to the line all that often since he's been playing along the perimeter. He's 14 of 19, make it 15 of 20. I'll do the math. That's 75% from the charity stripe.
Well, Ron Cottrell and his staff have their team well prepared here today, giving SFA all they want here in the first 11 minutes of the contest.
If HBU can make a stop, they'll have a chance to take the lead with a field goal.
Well, it was just a six-point ball game when they played at HBU earlier in the year, so the Huskies know they can play with them.
Odunsi lobs up ahead. To work his way out for a shot. Ultimately, just couldn't get to go. Cody Stettler.
Yeah, Stettler could have given him the lead, believe it or not.
Walk up the next man headed to the free throw line.
Well, I'm just going to say it again. I'm impressed with the way HBU kept their poise, getting down 9-0 early. Did not let them phase them. Come back, make that basket. They would have been ahead. But Thomas Walkup, two-time consecutive player of the year in the league. Now, he really looks like a lumberjack, doesn't he?
Put some flannel on him, and he'll be ready to come out for football season next year on the sidelines. He might be dribbling a basketball instead.
Oh, he's such a nice young man, great student.
Graduated this past December. As Ty Charles comes back on. And back to the bench goes Jared Johnson. And a breather for the big man, Cody Stettler. Walkup's in double digits with 10.
Well, Walkup in the 79% free throw shooter. Never a surprise when he knocks them both down.
Ball stripped away by Giffard on the deck. Let's see if he got a timeout. No, it'll be a foul on HBU. That means free throws again.
Well, that harassing defense that SFA plays is just relentless. They never give you a chance to take a breath or relax when you have the ball offensively.
It's the second personal foul on Alex Fountain.
Nice look at the big crowd of SFA fans here. The way the seating is configured for these tournaments, you can see that section right behind the HBU bench. That's where the fans of Texas A&M Corpus Christi will be sitting. But down on the other end and going all the way up high is all SFA fans. So great support here from Nacogdoches and the Houston area.
Giffard pokes that ball loose, falls on it. And they get the foul moments later on his back, Alex Fountain.
Well, that's just a great picture of how SFA converges around the basketball. Their team defensive rotations all based on reaction.
Brad Underwood reminded us yesterday they finished on a three-game road swing. San Antonio, Nacogdoches, Louisiana, Huntsville, Texas. They had not been home since Senior Day on February 27th, so it was good for them to get that rest and a chance to go back over to Johnson Coliseum. By the way, Johnson Coliseum has been kind to Stephen F. Austin. This senior class never lost a game in its last 4 years in Southland Conference play at home.
Well, that's something to be very, very proud of. And, of course, they've got the great fan support there. Best in the Southland Conference, really one of the best fan supporting systems in the entire state of Texas in major college basketball. Remember that first conference game of the year when Sam Houston State went over there and they had over 7,000 people there, sold it out.
Yeah, during Brad Underwood's time, season tickets have gone up tenfold. Obviously, a new court this year, new video boards. Robert Hill is thrilled with all the positive feedback that both his basketball programs have brought to campus. Of course, Robert Hill, the athletic director over there in Nacogdoches. But great things happening. There's a reason why Brad Underwood each year has received job offers and each year decided he wanted to be a Lumberjack again going into the next season.
Well, he's really got everything in place in Nacogdoches that you can possibly need to be successful. And of course, Brad Underwood came well trained, longtime assistant coach at Kansas State and South Carolina, where he was associate head coach at both places.
Yeah, coached under both Bob Huggins and Frank Martin up there in Manhattan.
You know, and he was a head coach at two very prestigious junior college programs up at Dodge City, Kansas Junior College and at Delray Beach Junior College in Florida. Of course, Ron Cottrell, he was an assistant under Nolan Richardson at Arkansas. Yeah. So both these coaches well trained.
Very good lineage. Giffard made his free throws. He actually first met Brad Underwood when he came to a Kansas State camp during the offseason. They go low and headed to the free throw line. In a moment will be Coulter Lasher's 16th foul on the number one seed Lumberjacks.
Well, that was well executed. I was very impressed. Caleb Creighton made that nice pass from out past the head of the circle after Coulter Lasher flashed up and then went back. Middle of the floor was wide open because Stephen F. Austin was out pressuring tough on the wings.
1 more free throw for Lasher, the Anchorage, Alaska native, who's a 57% free throw shooter this year. Well, HBU is the surprise story in the Southland Conference, finishing with one of those coveted top four seeds as Lasher makes the back end. This was a Huskies team that, when you looked and spoke to coaches and SIDs, much lower expectations. They were preseason pick 9th. Of course, in this league, that means you're not coming to Katy. Well, they didn't have to come to Katy until a day later after getting a day off.
They far exceeded that, obviously. But how about that nice move on the cleared side by Ty Charles?
Driving in, Odunsi, the all-conference guard for HBU.
Nice quick touch passes made that move possible for Odunsi. Isn't that something?
Buy a ticket, sit back and watch Thomas walk up.
One-on-one, you're not going to guard him. There was no help there at all.
Holds his own defensively as well. Three-year member of the all-defensive squad. Up ahead. One of the easier assists he'll have to Meech Floyd.
Nice look up the floor quickly by Walkup.
You get a reach in either on Walkup or on Pinckney.
Lincoln, that last pass, of course, Walkup made the great play defensively. Then he gets the pass up the floor. You can see he leads the team in assists, scoring, and rebounding. SFA up 32-24 with 6:54 to go in the first half.
Huskies trying to keep their dream season going as the number 4 seed here in the Southland Conference Men's Basketball Tournament. These two programs meeting for the first time back in 1968. Obviously not sharing a conference back then, but HBU looking for the upset. Bear in mind, I mentioned Brad Underwood, 53-1 against Southland Conference. That's in the regular season. Of course, he's a perfect 4-0 here in the conference tournament as the top Lumberjack. Each time winning both the semifinal and the final here in the men's tournament.
Lincoln, we've talked a lot about HBU and the success they're having now, and they've done a terrific job, but I'll tell you one thing they're going to have to do to get their program really to the level like Stephen F. Austin or Sam Houston or Texas A&M Corpus Christi. They got to get a better arena to play in. That Sharp Gymnasium's been there, what, long, long time, and it only seats about 1,000. So that's an area where they can certainly improve.
It certainly got loud in a hurry this year with standing room only with the season that the Huskies were having. Last year they celebrated their 50th year of basketball. Second half century off to a great start. It was a 10-3 run for SFA before those free throws by the Huskies. Walk up with a dozen, make it 14
How
for the senior.
How about that? Great start by Thomas Walkup. Now 14 points, 2 rebounds, 2 assists, and 1 block. Pretty good indicator of his terrific versatility.
Dunsey with a hand in his face misses from 15. Charles has space. Holyfield with his 8th rebound. He'll be stripped away, but Lumberjacks sail to haul it in.
Holyfield's doing a very good job of going after those long rebounds. That's enabling him to get some big totals here early this afternoon.
One-on-one, and the reach-in will lead to the double bonus for Walkup.
It is just so much fun to watch a really smart basketball player just dissect the defense. Look at Walkup checking everything out, sees that little crease in the orange-shirted Huskies defense, takes that first big quick step and explodes to the bucket. Now he has a chance to get points 15 and 16.
Second foul on Chukwujekwu here in the opening half. Thomas Walkup is from these parts, mentioned out of Deer Park High School, calls Pasadena, Texas home.
I still remember his brother that had such a great career at Texas A&M.
And this is now the largest lead for your regular season champion, Lumberjacks. A double-digit advantage. Huskies had trimmed a 9-point deficit all the way down to 1, but never able to get over the hump.
Look at that one-on-one defense by Pinckney, just sliding his feet perfectly.
And Cantwell with a shove to the player of the year.
Yeah, no doubt about that. That's a good call by James Durham. That wasn't even necessary. I think that's frustration a little bit.
Got to be careful. Just a common foul.
Yeah, take a look. This wasn't necessary at all. He just pushes him off. Bragging on the Huskies' composure coming back from that 9-0 deficit, but that was not a smart play by Cantwell that time.
Ron Cottrell is going to call a timeout. Let his team cool down for a moment.
Well, I really think that was called by the officials, Lincoln. I think they're checking the monitor to see if that may have been
a flagrant
foul on that. I don't think it was. It certainly was not smart, but I don't think it was flagrant. You can see Ron Cottrell right there pleading his case to his team to stay under control as they have been for the entire game till right now.
I'll say when we saw the replay, it didn't look quite as bad as it looked live.
Mm-mm. Well, and it was just 5 feet from James Durham, the official, so he was right there on it. Game this important, they're going to go to the monitor at every opportunity that they think is necessary. I don't think we're going to have any call made on this other than just a normal foul.
Well, we talk about this Huskies team. They made it to the NCAA tournament back in 1984. They are hoping to end that drought, the NCAA postseason. As officials will go to both huddles, let's see what they've determined. It appears it'll just remain a common foul as HBU will return to the free throw lane. And we appreciate James Durham coming over, and it is, in fact, a common foul.
Yeah, just a common foul, and that's a nice piece of officiating there. It's always better to check.
The again. Double bonus. First free throw good. 17 points for Thomas Walkup, who had a doozy in Huntsville. Went on to that career-high 38.
And you know what? He did that 38 against a really outstanding defensive team. Sam Houston State, one of the best defensive ball clubs in the Southland.
He was a one-man wrecking ball at one point.
Well, you're not going to guard him one-on-one. You have always got to have help when he's going to the basket. Nice cut by Duncey.
Duncey goes into the body. Can't get the shot to fall, but Anthony will be shooting two here in just a moment. 6 points for the Houston native early on.
Now, Duncey's such a great competitor. He finds a way to make things happen. There's three defenders right there, but he did enough faking and used his quickness and power to get to the basket and draw the foul. That's why I mentioned earlier, number three in the nation in free throws attempted this year and made.
Yeah, we saw that on display yesterday with Odunsi against Southeastern when he was 12 for 12 at the line. Walkup will get his second breather.
Yeah, that's a rarity when you see Odunsi miss a free throw. He's an 84% marksman from the line. My goodness, missed two. That's really a rarity.
But hopefully it wasn't lost when you mentioned it a moment ago. Of all the players in the country in Division I, 351 programs, each with about 15 on their roster, he's number three in the nation in free throws.
Well, he just has a knack for drawing the foul, and he always takes it hard to the basket. That will get you to that strike.
Ty Charles goes blowing right through the HPU bench.
Now, there's an exhibit of athleticism. That was pretty impressive. Looked like a triple jumper going over those chairs.
Could have easily tweaked his ankle, but he appears to be okay.
Well, both these ball clubs playing so hard here this afternoon in this semifinal of an outstanding Southland Conference postseason tournament.
Trailing by a dozen at the moment. Double dribble won't help.
Well, Coulter, last year he was just being harassed out there by the 6'8 Holyfield. The freshman just keeps the pressure on. They do not let their opponent relax, and that's what happened to Lasher right there.
This was an 82-54 victory the last time these two teams met. That was in Nacogdoches. They met earlier in the year, a closer affair in Houston, a 6-point ball game, as Jim Haller noted earlier. And an excellent job defensively by HBU. Holding his ground was Osuji.
Well, that was a nice rotation by Houston Baptist right there.
Pinkney, 2-on-2. Cutting through is Floyd, and he'll take it to the rim.
Lincoln, we're always talking about quick feet defensively, but watch this Stephen F. Austin team, the way they use quick hands to make things happen. They get close. They're taking a swat at that basketball.
9 points for Demetrius Floyd in this opening half. It's an 8-0 run for the number one seed. And HBU is finally back in the scoring column thanks to Coulter Lasher.
Heads up play by Lasher. Read that defense well.
Fired in. And before the shot, a foul on the floor. Free throws coming up when we come back. SFA will be at the line looking to build on a dozen-point advantage.
I got it.
Thank you. What do you have on that graphic? Live at the Merrill Center here in Katy, Texas. 3:24 left in the first half. SFA leading HBU 40-28. Coming up for the Mid-South Bank halftime report. We got a lot coming your way as we take a break momentarily and get ready for a big second half between the Lumberjacks and the Huskies. We're going to be joined by the mayor of Katy. Fable Hughes will join me. We'll talk about what's happening in this city as they host yet another Southland Conference tournament. Also, we'll talk from Houston Methodist West trainer Lane Schramm will join us. We'll talk about injuries and how they overcome them in the basketball realm of things. We'll also have highlights and much more coming up again on the Mid-South Bank Halftime Report. Right now, toss it back down to Lincoln and Jim.
Thank you very much, Randy McAvoy. Thrilled to have him each and every year up there in his perch looking down at us at the Merrill Center. Set to go for the Mid-South Bank Halftime Report. When I see Randy, it's a reminder that, of course, these two teams weren't here on day one. You and Randy had the call of that classic double overtime game between the men of Nichols and McNeese State. Always drama in the opening rounds here in Southland.
Well, those were both great games for opening rounds, and Randy, as always, did a terrific job.
And again, it'll be double bonus for both teams from here on
Brad
out.
Brad Underwood not happy with that foul right there. Jordan Stickler going to the line for the Huskies.
Stickler out of Annapolis, Maryland. Most recently was at Blinn Junior College up the road in the Bryan College Station area.
Now I'll tell you an amazing statistic about Stickler. He's actually number one in the Southland Conference in three-point shooting percentage, hitting 46% on the year.
At limited opportunities at the free throw line, though, was 17 of 20 coming into today. Split that pair. Floyd goes hard to the rack.
Oh, he went hard, but how about that speed and pick quickness by Demetrius Floyd?
Flipped it into gear. He's in double figures with 11. And this ball's back over to SFA. I think they thought Pinckney touched it last. Let's see if our officials come together.
Now, Pinckney did a great job of selling that also. Ron Cottrell looking on from across the court.
Officials came together and confirmed it was, in fact, Stephen F. Austin basketball. All of this most recently with Thomas Walkup getting a breather on the bench. They'll appreciate that in the second half.
Well, watch how Stephen F. Austin just keeps moving players off of those picks at the high post.
Meech. Oh, a fan favorite for the folks in Nacogdoches, Texas. Demetrius Floyd has been known to drain the three. A 42% shooter from beyond the arc. And this now the greatest advantage, 18 for SFA.
Floyd showing us why he was a second team All-Southland Conference selection. Can hurt you in a lot of ways. Talked about his quickness on the drive on the baseline, but then he just stops quickly and takes that three ball jump shot out there. Nice kick back to him from Gaffard.
And after this, SFA will now keep the basketball. There is a foul moments later on Coulter Lasher, his second. You'll get to see another look at that shot from Demetrius Floyd.
Now see, he just kicks it off to the high post right back to Floyd. Just nice teamwork. But you could see the foul there in the background off of that shot.
Floyd, one of five seniors on this year's squad. For Brad Underwood, obviously a group headlined by Thomas Walkup, but several of them made their debut last year as junior college transfers, and that's why Brad Underwood was optimistic about this year. They were all coming back, and as good as the last 2 years have been under Brad Underwood, he thought this could be even more special. Also said they look the part. This is one of the taller teams he has had.
But what makes that man tick and what makes him happiest is what he told us yesterday, why he considered this the best of his three teams in Nacogdoches, because it's the best defensive team. And you can see they're playing against a very, very outstanding offensive ball club in Houston Baptist. Houston Baptist averages 77 points per game. But this defense of SFA has just harassed them so that they are held to just 29 points now with 2:22 to go in the first half.
For much of this season, out of the 351 Division I men's basketball programs, SFA has been top 10 in steals per game. And for the most part, they've been the number one team in the nation in forced turnovers per contest at almost 19.
Well, these striped shirts are getting their money's worth out of the replay monitor here this afternoon. I think this is the third time they've already been to the monitor in this game.
That's Kerry Sitton and James Durham at the monitor. And we're reminded oftentimes at these tournaments that officiating can run in the blood just like coaching in the sport of basketball can. We saw Kerry Sitton's son work a women's tournament game earlier today.
You're talking about the prowess of SFA and their national rankings, but something that really gets my attention is their status in this league. They're the number one scoring offensive team, averaging right at 80 points per game, but they're also the number one scoring defensive ball club in the conference, holding the opponents to only 63 per outing. So that's a great combination when you can be number one on offense and number one on defense.
Remember, what led to all this was Colter Lasher being called for a foul after the Floyd three-pointer. Our officials are coming together right now. The ball was not in play at the time. Let's see how they get it all sorted out as they brought Toby Martinez into the huddle as well. The alternate official, Joe Wilbert, for this ball game at the monitor. If you can read facial expressions, we'll soon find out what the verdict is.
Yeah, James Durham's going to come over and tell us right now.
Dead ball contact, technical foul on number five.
Dead ball contact foul on number five for Colter Lasher for Houston Baptist.
And
that will be a technical.
Technical at that. That's correct.
Yeah, we appreciate James Durham coming over and making sure we were informed where we could let all you fans know what was happening. Here's a better wide look at it. Look up at the top of your screen now as the action starts back the other way. You could see Lasher right there. He did raise his forearm and elbow up, and anytime you make contact in the head area, that is a severe penalty.
So Giffard shoots the technicals. Now possession belongs to Stephen F. Austin following the foul, with a 20-point lead established for the first time here today. Stephen F. Austin right now is number two in the nation in scoring discrepancy this year. Their average margin is plus 17 against their opponent this season. Michigan State is a fraction better. Floyd.
Well, Floyd's got that quick release coming off of those screens. He can hurt you driving off of the pick or jumping up and shooting over it.
This is already essentially a five-point possession for Stephen F. Austin. The three-pointer from Floyd, the two technical free throws, and another chance for second-chance points here. Floyd with a closer look. Sure enough, he had five of the 7 points this trip down the floor.
Well, burns you on the three ball, then comes back when you try to guard him closely on the perimeter and takes it hard with its quickness on the drive. Now has 14 points.
And make it 16 now. They update. It's a 11-0 run. They'll go inside of the big man. Just too strong. Rebound by Giffard.
Well, Stettler just, I believe he's a little bit rattled by this aggressiveness of the SFA defense. He's missed some easy shots in there. Youngsters playing hard, just can't get the reward.
Travel a moment later, turnover on Stephen F. Austin. Using that half-court line to their advantage, the defense of the Lumberjacks.
Three ball in the air, able to drop through. Some good news for HBU, courtesy of Caleb Creighton. He's got 10 points, had six all of yesterday in the win over Southeastern.
Well, and he's excelling in both areas of the game. He's taking it on the drive, and he's hit a couple of long balls, so he's certainly trying to do his part, Lincoln.
Brad Underwood asked for a timeout. Is he thinking about getting in two possessions before the half?
I'm sure he is. That's a strategy I certainly believe in. With 49 seconds to go, we'll have that chance.
Brad Underwood gathers the troops. This is a special year for him. His son, Tyler, is a freshman who's redshirting. Tyler was injured his senior year in high school, so saw some offers from other schools drop off. He's sitting out this year, working his way back from injury. Should be good to go next season as a second-year freshman. They're also excited about Johnny Dahl, an Iowa native, who will be a redshirt freshman next year as well for the Lumberjacks. But good things on the horizon for SFA, and neither of these teams ready to say farewell to this great season that they've both had.
Stephen F. Austin, good balance here in the first half, getting 51 points. They've had six different players score, and certainly that's been led by the prowess of Thomas Walkup and Nietzsche Floyd.
Now, the Lumberjacks have not scored 100 points this year. It's not necessarily a goal of theirs either. Obviously, at the moment, on pace, Floyd.
Well, look at DeFrard, the sky up there for that rebound. I mean, that's Ty Charles, I'm sorry.
SFA 0 for 3 this trip down. Shot clock is off. HBU should be able to hold for the final score if they can hang on to the basketball. And out of bounds the call before the timeout by Stetler. His foot was on the line.
Well, great hustle by Stetler, but he did slide out of bounds on that possession. Well, look at this great hustle by the big fella.
And the official saying his knee was on that interior blue line before he signaled for the timeout. 10 seconds to get one off here. Lobbed into Charles, too tall. Still time with three to shoot. Floyd at the buzzer. An appropriate end to the opening first half, dominated by the team that went perfect through Southland play. And a technical on Ron Cottrell heading into the locker room.
Well, tough physical basketball game. I personally think the referees have done a good job of keeping it under control. But right here is going to be an example of how important offensive rebounds are. Stephen F. Austin has dominated in that area of the game, and they just kicked it out for another one for Floyd. What a half that young man has had. 19 points now for Michi Floyd, 18 for Thomas Walkup. Look at that release on that ball.
The defending champs are back in Katy. Their presence known, up big, 54-32, all of this part of Champ Week on ESPN. Mid-South Bank Halftime Report with Randy McAvoy when we come back to the Merrill Center.
Right there is good.
Right here?
Yeah.
Okay. Say that again. Mid-South Bank halftime.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome our contestants to the floor for the Wild Women Cafe.
Yeah, it's going to take a mammoth effort for this other team to get back in next second half, though. It was a good game right there. They had a chance to go ahead by one run, one point.
Yeah.
The other way. Didn't help there. They're still a good quality team. That right here.
Okay. How long do you want me to go with Fable?
All I need to know is how much time to fill. I know you and I will just fill it. It's going to fly by. It's going to be.
Oh, I know.
Halftime's not that long. So.
I've done these many times already. Yeah. Amazing.
All right,
quick.
All right, here we go. 5 seconds.
All right.
So I'm going to hold that mic about right there.
All right. Gotcha.
And welcome back to the Merrill Center in Katy, Texas, the Mid-South Bank halftime report. Stephen F. Austin, the number one seed, leading Houston Baptist 54-32. All right, we get underway now in our halftime report. We'll get back to the second half. Check out the highlights momentarily. Again, all SFA so far in this first half. They're in control. Big first half from Demetrius Floyd. And also Player of the Year, Thomas Walkup as well, 54-32. Lumberjacks on top. Pleasure to be joined now by the mayor of Katy. He's joined me each and every year. It's always good to see him. Let's welcome in Fable Hughes, third year as the mayor of Katy. And great to see you again each and every year out here.
Thank you.
What's it mean for the city to host such a great event?
This is such a great event for the city, and it brings in a lot of money. Brings in a lot of good people, but it's good for the schools, too. They take home money from this, too. Every year, this gets bigger and bigger. This is the ninth year the city's hosted this tournament. It's bigger and bigger every year. We have excellent competition every year. Excellent competition. Anybody can beat anybody. And we have, like I told you earlier, we have 8 hotels on the ground out right now, and we have 3 more on the drawing board. We fill them up every year at this time.
Well, great fan support that comes here for this tournament each and every year. This is a great neutral site, too, for a lot of teams that want to make it here. And it's a good destination when it comes tournament time.
It certainly is. And we welcome these folks to come in here and spend the weekend with us.
This is not a sleepy town anymore. Katy has shown tremendous growth over the years. And although that's important to you as the mayor of the city. The growth of this city is really taking off. This is not a sleepy town anymore.
That's true. When we first moved here 44 years ago, we had less than 3,000 people. And now we're over 17,000 people. Just tremendous growth. And it's been a real pleasure the last 3 years to work with it and keep up with it.
Very good. Always good to catch up with you. I know you're enjoying some basketball today. You guys do a tremendous job in the city of Katy.
Great game we're watching. It was real close there at one time, and unfortunately HBU let it get away. But they have a mammoth chore ahead of them to try to get back in.
Well, still second half ahead. We're going to find out. Always good to see you.
Yeah. Thank you, Randy.
Fable Hughes, mayor of the city of Katy. Pleasure to be with us here on the Mid-South Bank Halftime Report. We've got more coming up. Stephen F. Austin leading Houston Baptist 54-32. Got it. Say that again, Mike.
Just a little closer. It's got to square up, and it's a mic about right there.
Yes, sir.
Back live at the Merrill Center in Katy, Texas. Welcome back to the Mid-South Bank Halftime Report. Stephen F. Austin, the top-seeded Lumberjacks, leading the Huskies of Houston Baptist 54-32. The winner, of course, moving on to tomorrow's championship game. All right, pleasure to be joined now by Lane Schramm. He's with Houston Methodist West athletic trainer out there. Good to see you. We spoke last year as well. Always good to see you.
Good to see you as well.
Catch up a little bit. Talk about being here and being a part of this tournament. I know it's important not only for you but all the folks at Houston Methodist West.
Yes, sir. At Houston Methodist West, we've been out. We're trying to be big in the community. This is our fourth, fifth year to help out with the tournament. We enjoy it every year. We try to help out the student athletes here in the community, also in the, you know, in this, the wide array of the Southland Conference. And as the community continues to grow, the hospital's growing. We're about to start phase two of our expansion process. We're going to double in size by the year 2018.
Much like the city of Katy, we just spoke with Mayor Fable Hughes. City of Katy's really growing. You guys are certainly a part of that. I want to ask you, I think it's fascinating how the medicine and treatment has changed over the years when it comes to injuries. You guys can now, with technology, get players back in action, back on the court, in this case with basketball, a lot quicker than you used to maybe 10, 15 years ago.
Correct. Yeah, the biggest key is what we try to do out of, you know, with our Houston Methodist West is get the individual to the hospital, not to the hospital, but to see a doctor as soon as possible. Because as soon as you can diagnose the injury, then the treatment process begins. So I know we've had a couple people go in and out, and we try to get in the same day process. And the sooner we can get them in, the sooner the healing process starts.
Lastly, you got a big day today. You got more basketball over the weekend. This is a fun weekend. If you're a basketball fan, you guys are part of it.
Oh, yes, sir. Love it. Love every minute of it.
Very good. Lane Schramm, athletic trainer of Houston Methodist West. Always good to catch up. Thanks for stopping by. Enjoy the tournament.
Will do, sir. Thank you.
All right, more of the Mid-South Bank Halftime Report coming up. Stephen F. Austin leading Houston Baptist. What's coming up next? Am I going to pitch it down to okay.
Coverage of Champ Week on ESPN continues here in the Southland Conference in Katy, Texas. As we welcome you back to the Mid-South Bank Halftime Report, I said Ron Cottrell got a technical. I was incorrect. It is a double player technical. As you see right there, a couple of players simply voicing their opinions back and forth. Cody Stettler picked it up for HBU. Clyde Giffard for Stephen F. Austin. With a double technical, no free throws will result as both teams headed back to the locker room. Let's take a look at our first half statistics brought to you by Mid-South Bank. Obviously a 22-point discrepancy on the board, but SFA no stranger getting to the free throw line in that first half.
Well, how about that? 18 out of 18 to go with all the other effectiveness they've had here this afternoon. Second chance points, the big reason right there for part of this lead to be so significant, 12-2. And of course, they have forced Houston Baptist into 10 turnovers to only 2 for SFA. Points off turnovers, 16-3. So you can see SFA taking advantage of the mistakes by the Huskies in the first half.
SFA has been one of the top teams in the nation all year long, capitalizing off of turnovers.
And, of course, we all know about Thomas Waka, but he is not the only man who steps up for the Lumberjacks. On the big stage today, Demetrius Floyd has come through.
Well, Floyd has just been so impressive using his quickness there. He just used his speed getting down the floor here, reading the defense, getting the layup in transition right there, using that great quick first step on the baseline. Just doing it all to help SFA get this commanding lead at the halftime. And then Thomas Walkup on the other side of the coin, what a great job he has done in all phases of the game. Has two assists. He's got the 18 points. He's clearing a side for SFA's clearing the side so Walkup can make the good moves on the to the bucket. Just very, very effective here this afternoon.
Thomas Walkup now has 56 points in his last three halves of basketball here against Southland Conference opposition. Those 18 free throws on 18 attempts. Right now, the Southland Conference tournament record is 22 for 22. That was by Texas State a little over a decade ago. SFA clearly on the way, if they can stay perfect, of shattering that mark.
Well, they've just done, we keep talking about their offense, but their defense is equally impressive. Here they're holding a ball club averaging 77 points per game to only 32 points in the first half. Their team defensive rotations is just terrific in my mind, and they always play such harassing, never let your opponent get comfortable, Lincoln, and that's never more evident than this semifinal game here this afternoon.
The burden is on HBU to come out with a quicker start than they had in the opening half when it was a 9-0 run for the number one seed when they made their debut earlier today here in Katy. They're looking to get back to the final for a fourth straight year when this is all said and done.
Southland Conference Basketball on ESPN3, brought to you by Mid-South Bank, the official bank of the Southland Conference. It's time to love your bank. By Houston Methodist West Hospital, leading medicine. And by Universal Coin and Bullion, America's gold expert, the official rare coin and bullion dealer of the Southland Conference.
Huskies break the huddle. Houston Baptist founded back in 1960. 3 years later, its first season of men's basketball. And Ron Cottrell now in his 24th year at the helm. I mentioned as the eighth longest tenure among all active Division I head coaches. And across the way for Stephen F. Austin, Brad Underwood. 3 years at the helm. Now the three-time Southland Conference Coach of the Year. We saw a lot of coaches in this league, including Willis Wilson and Jason Hooten, who certainly had a claim for that title. But if you're 18-0 in conference, it's hard to argue otherwise.
Well, I agree 100%, Lincoln. When you've got that target on your back after being a two-time defending conference champion and make it through that third season 18-0, you've done a terrific coaching job, and he deserves all the accolades he can get. Here we have the second half starting with the normal throw in after that double technical foul, which offsets. We just play as usual.
I don't want to leave Ron Cottrell out of the conversation either for potentially Southland Conference Coach of the Year. Obviously, they started 8-0 in league play, and they start off a lot quicker. It's Creighton was in double figures going into halftime. He's got a dozen now here today in the semifinals.
Well, that was a nice call play by Ron Cottrell to start that second half, taking advantage of that overplay pressure defense by SFA.
Floyd had the buzzer beater, and he's hit the last 6 points now for SFA.
Boy, he has got the hot hand here this afternoon, and Demetrius Floyd, he has a career high of 32 at UNO back in January. We can be on a career high watch here this afternoon.
Yeah, right now he's got the double deuce, 22 points. His teammate Pinckney just picked up his second personal.
Well, you've got Floyd.
Robinson was looking for Odunsi.
What I was going to say, Floyd and Walkup have combined for 42 points. How about that? Another one. So they've now combined for 45 points here this afternoon. 43.
Meech has 25. A little heat check to confirm he's on fire. Odunsi. And the senior able to draw a foul out on Stephen F. Austin. Let's not forget, Thomas Walkup was able to be a spectator much of the end of that first half. Got an extended breather.
Yeah, Walkup only played 13 minutes, and how about this for production? 18 points, 4 rebounds, 2 assists, and 1 block shot in 13 minutes of action. Well rested coming in here to the second 20 minutes of action. But going back to Michi Floyd, 32-point career high, which he got against UNO back in January. All he needs is 8 more to break that record of his this afternoon.
The foul was on Trey Pinckney. He takes a seat with his third personal. Now, Brad Underwood, I would not have been surprised if he had left Pinckney out there. He has such a deep team, and these young men can plug in a variety of roles that he's not too concerned if one individual is in foul trouble. Charles, beautiful pass into the freshman Holyfield, who goes up strong.
Now, Todd Charles is a terrific talent that gets overlooked by so many of these stars on the SFA team, but that was a pass deluxe.
And Dallas Cameron will likely be picking up this next foul, putting Odunsi back at the free throw line.
You mentioned Trey Pinckney had gone to the bench with 3 fouls. He has not fouled out of a single game this year, so he plays that tough, harassing pressure defense out front on the ball handler of the opponent, and has done that in grand style all year.
Anthony Odunsi, his second year at HBU. This is his 4th college basketball team. He was a starter as a freshman at Utah, transferred to Tyler Junior College, was at Albany most recently before finally becoming a Husky last year. He was recruited out of high school by HBU. Ron Cottrell knew him because he went to high school with Cottrell's daughters over in Sugarland at Travis High School in the Fort Bend Independent School District. Floyd gets his own rebound. A foul underneath on Creighton.
A nice job by Ty Charles following his own missed shot right there. Youngster that comes out of Kennedale, Texas.
Second foul on the senior Odunsi. Ty Charles is a 75% free throw shooter. Was the only underclassman on the preseason all-conference lists before the start of this year. This is often a senior-dominated league. There was a shakeup this season.
Oh, was that the first miss of the afternoon?
That was.
Believe, yeah.
Follow won't go. Ball stays with the men in purple and white.
Now there's another one of those offensive rebounds that's been plaguing Houston Baptist all day.
Charles kicks out to Holyfield. And they wave off what would have been his second three-pointer because of a 3-second call in the lane.
And that time, Houston Baptist was in a zone defense, trying anything to slow down this attack of the Lumberjacks.
That would have either been on Charles or Walkup. Odunsi.
Oh, good pick out by Odunsi. Good vision.
Give the assist to Odunsi. He was able to spot Jordan Stickler open on the wing.
Well, that was great penetration by Odunsi and even better vision. Pass that ball out of traffic to his wide-open teammate.
As you noted earlier, Stickler led the Southland Conference this year, now better than 46% from beyond the arc. Shot clock halfway down. Long jumper for two along that baseline from Holyfield.
The beautiful movement of the basketball against that zone. Houston Baptist, second time in a row back in that defense, but SFA passed the ball quicker than the Huskies could move.
SFA led the nation last year in assists. They've been in the top five much of this year. Obviously, the big loss for SFA was a former Southland Player of the Year in Jacob Parker this past offseason, but Brad Underwood said, look, we can replace that talent. It's the fact that Parker never made the wrong decision out there on the floor, whether it be taking a shot or getting a teammate involved. But we've seen this basketball IQ of this year's group continue to rise throughout the season.
Well, SFA has had the Southland Player of the Year now four straight seasons.
Floyd does it again.
That youngster is literally on fire, playing with great confidence here this afternoon. 28 points with 16 and a half minutes left.
Again for the Lumberjacks, this is their debut into this year's tournament.
Well, they look fresh, quick.
Earning the double bye, A&M Corpus Christi has yet to step foot on this floor. They'll do it tonight against Sam Houston State. And they'll pull the 3 points right back. Creighton is having quite the night as well with his season on the line.
Well, that was good ball. Both ball clubs right now playing great offensively both ways, moving the ball well and getting the open shots and, most importantly, knocking them down.
15 points for Caleb Creighton, a senior playing for his own career. Walkup able to maintain that ball, throw it up. Free throws when we come back out of this break. But the Huskies continue to put up a fight. Caleb Creighton with three of his 15 here with still almost 16 minutes to play. Well, it's already been a basketball-filled week here in Katy for both the men and women's basketball tournaments in the Southland Conference. We invite you to bring the whole family out tomorrow, not just for basketball, for the Katy Kids Dribble as well. It'll start at 10 a.m. here at the Merrill Center, home of both tournaments, fun-filled day hoops, but also bounce houses, cheerleaders, and mascots for the kids to interact with. Free t-shirts and souvenirs for the first 300 kids in attendance. Free entry into the women's semifinal games. The quarterfinals, round two, was earlier today, including a Cinderella squad in Sam Houston State's women, the Bearcats, with upsets through the first two rounds as the seventh seed for the first time in their program's history, winning multiple games in Katy.
A walk-up trying to become the second Lumberjack to become a 20-point scorer here this afternoon if he can make another free throw. Lincoln, I don't think I've ever seen a ball club shoot 54% and be down 27 points.
HBU shot 50% in that first half and found themselves down by 22. Obviously, that deficit's now grown.
I can tell you why that's happening. Right now, Stephen F. Austin is out-rebounding Houston Baptist 26-12, but most importantly, 13-1 on the offensive boards. That is severe. When you add all that up, Stephen F. Austin is advantaged 19-6 off turnovers and 13-2 in second chance points. That's 24 points right there.
That's the third foul on Clyde Giffard. HBU will look to come away with points here with Jordan Stickler at the free throw line. You saw Stickler's three-pointer going into that last break with a great pass from Odunsi. But HBU can score all the points they want, but they also need to stop SFA. The Lumberjacks have scored on all seven of their possessions here coming out of the locker room.
Well, both ball clubs have looked good in the second half offensively, but as we keep talking, the difference maker, the rebounding of Stephen F. Austin in this game, just totally dominating, especially on that offensive glass, 13-1. And they have forced Houston Baptist into 11 turnovers to only 3 for the Lumberjacks. Boy, at the pace SFA plays, to just have 3 turnovers in a game this physical, that's very, very impressive.
SFA only had 2 conference games in which they scored in excess of 90 points. 97 was their highest tally against Abilene Christian earlier this year back in January.
Well, you just watch Stephen F. Austin. They make their cuts off these screens at the high post. Just beautiful.
His name is Demetrius Floyd. His friends and fans simply call him Meech. And he has been fantastic now. 30 points primarily from beyond the arc.
I bet Brad Underwood sitting over there thinking, I wish he'd save a few of these for the championship game tomorrow.
That game tomorrow, if SFA is there, will come against either the 2 or the 3 seed, Islanders or Bearcats. A chance for a 3-point possession here.
SFA continuing to be nearly flawless. Another assist for Thomas Walkup, and Ty Charles getting a nice break to the basket from that left wing, running the floor very, very well. And Demetrius Floyd coming out of the ball game. Thomas Walkup coming out of the ball game with 14:44 to go. Both of them 20-point scorers here. They've combined for 50 of the Stephen F. Austin 74 points.
Ty Charles with his 6th point. He struggled from the floor. Able to make up for it this last trip down.
First time we've seen C.J. Williams on the floor for Stephen F. Austin. He's a 6'7", 240-pound junior college transfer from Hill Junior College up in Hillsboro.
Dallas Cameron just picked up his 4th whistle, the first player for either team with 4 fouls. He was walking towards the bench. Brad Underwood asked, why are you coming over here? Stay in. I think he's going to think about it again, and we're going to see Thomas Walkup in just a moment. But that foul on Cameron was also the 7th team foul, so the bonus in effect with Cody Stettler at the line.
A nice form by Stettler. Talked earlier about his expertise. 6'4", 235 pounds, so strong.
Rebound down to Giffard. C.J. Williams is back in the ball game for the Lumberjacks, standing at the free throw line right now, trying to give them some size in the post. He sucked in a couple defenders, allowed Walkup to go straight off the glass. Walkup has 22, looking for point number 23 here in just a moment.
Well, look, we'll have a chance to replay this, but watch his strength and his follow-through. Good balance. He gets bumped severely on this kiss off the glass. this young man. I love the way they continue to clear the side for him and give him plenty of room to operate.
With 23 points, Thomas Walkup is only the second highest scorer on his own team here today. Odunsi. A rebound out to Cantwell and Asa. Again, had five yesterday, two here today in the semifinals.
I'll tell you, that kid's one of the best pure shooters I've seen this year anywhere.
Gaffard on the other end takes those 3 points right back.
Boy, I'm telling you, both ball clubs so impressive on the offensive end shooting right now.
It's a two-on-one. That will bring the remaining Lumberjack fans to their feet. The slam dunk from Jared Johnson, the senior.
Jared Johnson, another player on this SFA team from Hill College. He and Williams both have played together on very successful teams up there in Hillsboro.
Creighton having himself a day.
I tell you, he has been very impressive. I like his style, very confident. He wants the basketball.
I believe he's 4 for 4 from beyond the three-point line.
He balances up so well. Shooter's touch right there. Gaffard showing us why he should be. They don't honor that, but should be sixth man of the year in the Southland Conference. Doesn't start, but was selected third team all-conference.
Odunsi just loses the handle.
Well, I think it's safe to say Lincoln SFA is going to hit a season high in point total.
Well, HBU right now obviously with a mountain to climb with not quite 13 minutes to play, but as I noted a moment ago, Caleb Creighton is perfect today. 4 for 4 from beyond the arc, 6 for 6 from the floor. Also made both of his field goals, or I should say free throws. A little over 20 minutes of action.
SFA season high is 97 against Abilene Christian back on January 16th.
Charles straight away. Underneath. And an entanglement sends Gaffard to the floor. And again, you've got some Huskies already sitting on technicals. They'll need to be careful the rest of the way.
There's that offensive rebounding prowess of SFA continuing. They just crashed those offensive boards.
Stetler needs to be careful. Cody Stetler and Colter Lasher both have already been assessed a technical today for HBU. For Stetler, he was a part of that conversation going into halftime, and our officials are going to review the foul at the monitor across the way. Again, Kerry Stinton, James Durham at the monitor. Toby Martinez rounds out the crew today. And actually, Martinez will go up to the monitor in place of Durham. And I don't think you're going to see anything other than a common foul there.
I don't think that was intentional whatsoever. That was just a great job of Gaffard going hard to the offensive glass and Houston Baptist trying to block out on the play. Don't know, was that Fountain or who did?
Yeah, Alex Fountain was tangled.
Watch down here on the bottom right. Yeah, I think it was more of a case that Gaffard was just off balance. Don't think I've ever had a game where the officials went to the monitor so often. Now we're getting lots of looks at it. Let's take another one. But the big thing, just the effort on the offensive glass continuing so impressively for SFA, and they got it on the big screen up here.
I think there's a chance this will actually be assessed as a flagrant based on that last view, almost a toss from the hip. I won't be surprised either way. Our officials have come together. They're done looking at the monitors.
Well, they've gotten together quite often today to make sure they're all in agreement on what the call will be. And
it is the sixth team foul either way on HBU. It was on the floor, so no free throws. From a common foul, if it simply stays the way it was called on the floor. Again, it will be a personal foul on Fountain either way, which gives him 3. Question is whether there'll be a technical as well.
Well, this has been a very rough, physical, aggressive game from start to finish, and certainly right now, Houston Baptist a little frustrated. They're playing against one of the hottest teams in America right now, and SFA, I just keep talking about it, but their offensive rebounding here this afternoon has just been phenomenal, and that's what led to that situation that we're having discussed right now.
I'll let Jim Haller explain it as had the conversation.
Just had the conversation with official James Durham, and it is going to be a flagrant two call. Fountain of Houston Baptist will be ejected from the basketball game. They thought it was excessive when he flipped him over there at the end, but certainly you don't like to see that happen in a basketball game. But the call was made. Stephen F. Austin now will have two free throws and then get the ball out of bounds.
With that, HBU will lose a key reserve player who gives them about 5 points, three rebounds a ball game. You see the definition, not just a flagrant one, but a flagrant
you
two.
You see Fountain has to leave the bench area right now, and he is
carries the automatic ejection. That was just his first technical, or his, I should say flagrant. He'll be done for the day. But they did see his hand grab the bicep and toss the opposing player. So free throws and possession, we'll see coming up here for SFA. Clyde Gaffard, a 79% free throw shooter coming into today. Already 11 points.
Well, certainly Ron Cottrell, knowing the type of coach and man he is, he certainly does not like this. Not a reflection of the type of game he coaches, but anytime you have players going up against the undefeated conference champion, there's a little more emotion involved.
Well, it's been a special year for HBU. The problem is nobody has been able to knock off Stephen F. Austin in 18 tries this regular season.
Houston Baptist going back to the 2-3 zone, a real rarity for them. Don't do it very often.
Stephen F. Austin finished the only Division I program that went undefeated in conference play this year. So they have the nation's longest winning streak right now at 18 straight ball games coming into today. Their winning streak within the conference dates back to last year. It's 25 straight for Stephen F. Austin against conference foes. Backing his way in, Stetler can't get it to fall.
Well, look at Gaffard get up on the boards right there. There are some guys on this Lumberjack team with some big-time hops. Well, good ball movement continuing.
One of the smallest men on the floor was fighting for that rebound, and Jared Johnson for the Lumberjacks. Cantwell the other way. Stetler able to put his body on it. Cannot get the second chance point.
That was impressive the way Stetler held his position in there. Should have obviously gotten the put back, but goodness gracious, he worked hard to get position and hold it.
Well, I don't think anybody predicted that SFA would have a 35-point lead with more than a quarter remaining in the ball game. They just don't make enough mistakes.
Well, when you only have three turnovers and you have 87 points, that's indicative of a great, great floor game.
Creighton with the rebound.
Well, look at Holyfield get out there on that screen right there. That is so impressive for a big 6'8 youngster.
Good pass, finds Creighton, hasn't missed today. His first.
Well, you think Pinkney is quick? Goodness gracious.
It was a three-on-one break. That was one of the three. You got to leave two open. Ultimately, it's Jared Johnson who makes him pay.
Well, everybody on SFA's ball club hitting on big-time cylinders here this afternoon. Speed, quickness, energy, aggressiveness. They have literally got it all going.
Holyfield contested shot. The push put back good for Lasher.
You know, HBU continuing now in that 2-3 zone, just trying anything to slow down the precision of SFA, make them think about what they're doing a little bit. SFA has just driven the ball one-on-one at every opportunity.
Understand the luxury right now that Stephen F. Austin has. No Thomas Walkup on the floor. Assuming there's no disaster in terms of collapse today as Creighton gets two there.
Well, Caleb Creighton continuing to be so impressive. His 15th point of the ball game.
But assuming the Lumberjacks can hang on, they'll be well rested tomorrow against either the 2 seed or the 3 seed. They'll certainly be rooting for multiple overtimes tonight for the Bearcats and Islanders. Inside to Giffard, and he's got 15.
How about that job of positioning on the block by Giffard? Just terrific. Nice entry pass.
Lumberjacks, turnovers becoming points. Jared Johnson able to click the senior for three.
Have you been thinking about diversifying with gold but don't know how? Hi, I'm Mike Fulgens, president of Universal Coin and Bullion. As an award-winning nationwide dealer, we help clients get the answers they need to discover the beauty, security, and strength of gold in their portfolio.
Call us today at 866-UCB-GUIDE to receive our award-winning gold guide free. That's 866-822-4843.
There's one thing you can never have sex without.
It's not something you buy.
Or something you take.
In fact, there's only one way to get it.
It has to be given to you, freely.
It's consent.
Because sex without it isn't sex.
It's rape. Consent.
If you don't get it, you don't get it. It's on us to stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
At MidSouth Bank, we're dedicated to providing loans that allow our customers to achieve their business and personal dreams. That's one promise you can bank on. We're not just business associates, we're neighbors. We're committed to our customers and the strength of our local economy. Here at MidSouth Bank, responsibility matters. With locations in Texas and Louisiana and still growing, discover how our customers are finding strength in numbers at MidSouth Bank.
UniversalCoin.com brings us our Southland superlatives as, of course, Thomas Walkup, second straight year, the player of the year. His head coach, Brad Underwood, for a third straight year, receives top honors on the bench. Rashawn Thomas, your defensive player of the year, becomes the first Islander to claim that award. And, of course, the new blood, both freshman and newcomer of the year, goes the way of some men in purple over there in Abilene as well as Conway, Arkansas.
Yeah, Jalen Franklin of Abilene Christian and Derek Brooks of Central Arkansas, the two youngsters you're speaking of. Freshman of the year and newcomer of the year.
Robinson will throw it back out. And TJ Holyfield says, no, thank you. This stays with HBU. Holyfield with 11 points, flirting with a double-double, adds the block to his resume as well. It'll be HBU basketball when we come back with almost 9 minutes still to play. Brad Underwood, head coach at Stephen F. Austin, now in his third year. Of all head coaches in Division I through 3 years, he has the fourth highest winning percentage all time. He became the first Division I coach to pick up 61 wins in his first two seasons. But Brad Underwood obviously made a name for himself when in his rookie debut led Stephen F. Austin to a 32-3 mark, went 18-0 against the conference. They'd go on to beat Shaka Smart's Virginia Commonwealth squad in the opening round of the NCAA tournament before falling to UCLA in round two.
Well, that's the 14th turnover of the ball game for Houston Baptist now, and that continues to be the biggest difference maker in this Stephen F. Austin advantage. They now have 24 points to 6 in the points off turnover category.
Thomas Walkup remains on the bench. Any predictions whether we will see number 0 on the floor again tonight?
I don't think you'll see him at all. And certainly there goes Holyfield, just making a terrific quick move to the basket at 6'8". He is showing great, great dexterity and very, very good skills.
13 points for the freshman Holyfield. You have a feeling there's a handful of Islanders fans and Bearcats fans that are rooting for the Huskies in this one. And
well,
if they're filing into the arena, you may hear a few of them whisper, "Oh shoot." As SFA up by 38. A pass intended for Robinson, stolen by Gaffard.
Well, Gaffard just jumped into that passing lane. He was dropped off in the paint, and that's turnover number 15. But believe it or not, SFA, 94 points and only 3 turnovers. I don't think I've ever seen that before.
Nathan Bain is in the ballgame for the first time today for Stephen F. Austin. He's at the top of the key right now, cutting towards the baseline. Young man out of the Bahamas, just a true freshman. Huskies still have 7.5 minutes cut into this deficit.
The Lumberjacks have 4 players in double figures, just 1 for the Huskies of Houston Baptist. Caleb Creighton has 20. Nice move on that quick move to the basket by Chukwuke.
Young man out of Houston. Pinckney lobs it in, and there's Bain. Probably could have argued for goaltending in the rim by Robinson either way.
What
it goes.
A nice assist, though, by Pinckney. That's a picture-perfect pass.
Not have a lot of room to work with.
Well, Nathan Bain, you mentioned him coming on the floor. He's 6'6", another youngster with size and quickness and obviously good skills around the basket.
And that's continued success now for Chukwujeku, the junior.
Got 2 more points, and Stephen F. Austin will set a season high in scoring.
Pinckney leading this offense. And no rush to give the ball back over to the Huskies. Lobbed in. And Gaffar just could not finish with punctuation. Chukwujeku loses the handle, back over to Stephen F. Austin. Just moments ago, a little added excitement here in Katy. Flight 22 was cleared for takeoff. Well, I think we're both just in awe of Brad Underwood. We want to make sure people who are tuning in don't just think the Southland is a one-team league. You have to understand, if you follow this league, there are some incredible programs from top to bottom, especially the eighth that made their way here to Katy, Texas. But while all of them have improved and made big strides from a year ago, Stephen F. Austin still was not content with simply how last year ended. And Brad Underwood found a way somehow to put together a roster that is even stronger than the past two.
Well, and the best example of that, and we've talked about it often, is T.J. Holyfield coming in, being their starting center for all 30 games. Youngster going to the free throw line now. C.J. Williams is counted on to add some strength inside next year, particularly. He's 6'7", 240 pounds. Out of Hill College, he and Jared Johnson both. SFA now ties their season high on points. They had 97 against Abilene Christian back in mid-January. No, they break it, 98 now. He made both of those free throws, I'm sorry. So season high for the Lumberjacks.
Mentioned SFA has not reached triple digits.
This is a rarity, Lincoln, when you see Stephen F. Austin in a zone defense. They had a 2-3 that time.
And rebound down to the newest big man on the floor, Jaquan Smith, the junior transfer out of Baltimore. Bain takes the handoff, picks up his dribble. Cutting into the lane, and Robinson able to alter the shot. And a dueling big man in the post and getting the better of the exchange this time was Smith.
Well, that's two junior college transfers in there right now for the Lumberjacks, and both of them making their presence felt, and they're continuing to do what Stephen F. Austin has done so well the entire game, just crash the offensive glass. That was the 16th offensive rebound of the game for the Lumberjacks.
Jaquan Smith, a transfer out of Northern Oklahoma Junior College, is now 2-for-6 from the free throw line, limited opportunities. This is just his 16th ball game on the year.
Oh, what a nice touch right there on that free throw. Both JUCO guys now combined 3 out of 3 from the line.
Makes 1 of 2.
Well, the SFA crowd was hollering for that 100th point right there. They were wanting it.
Trey Patterson now with the basketball swings around in the ball game for HBU. Asa Cantwell had a game to remember yesterday. With 5 3-pointers. As the Lumberjacks will have a chance to crack the century mark here.
Stephen F. Austin shooting a even 50% for the ball game. Impressive 15 out of 26 here in the second half. Continuing to work for good shots.
Dallas Cameron is the closest thing to a veteran on the floor right now for Stephen F. Austin.
He started quite a few games in his career. He's an outstanding player.
But SFA has done themselves a great service by pulling away in this ball game. Again, they played the earlier game, the benefit for the number one seed. And they'll also likely watch the 2 and 3 seed tonight play a much tighter contest down the finish. And we're seeing the slightly less experienced group now on the floor together.
Well, it's really a shame. It's the turnovers are probably going to go up. But until this group came on the floor, Stephen F. continued to just have 3 turnovers in the entire game.
A free throw coming up. The foul whistled on C.J. Williams over the back. As Chukwu Jaku will shoot one.
Chico Jaku did make the nice move on the baseline. Liked his explosiveness going up to the basket.
Mentioned this is the first year for the HBU men in the Southland Conference Tournament. We saw the women last year with a phenomenal run all the way into the tournament final last year in that Sunday matchup. We came back this year. The women were eliminated in a double overtime contest, but just want to give a tip of the hat to Anna Strickland in that ball game. A matchup in which she exceeded 20 points, 30 rebounds, flirted with a quadruple-double. Here come the Huskies.
Well, how about that block by Isaiah Robinson? We were talking about the skills of the freshman for SFA, T.J. Holyfield, but this Robinson's got a great future. 6'10". Had, what, 3 or 4 blocks in their impressive victory last night over Southeastern Louisiana.
Less than 4 minutes separating Stephen F. Austin from another berth into the Southland Conference Tournament Final.
Got hoop fever? Katie's Wyoming Cafe's got the cure. We are the Southland Conference Basketball Tournament's official postgame headquarters. After the games, make a fast break for Wyoming Cafe's three-point platter. Three appetizers of your choice for one low price. Or try our famous wings for the best in Katie tossed in any of our 33 made-from-scratch flavors. Sip on Sam Adams Rebel Grapefruit IPAs or any of 21 ice-cold beers on tap. With TVs all around, we're ready for the madness at Wyoming Cafe. Katie's home for hot wings, cold beer, and good times.
I believe my inner child belongs on the outside.
I believe you should never be afraid to speak your mind.
I believe knowledge is free and can be shared with anyone.
I believe if you spend too much time looking back, you'll miss what's ahead, like a wall.
I believe with faith, the future isn't so intimidating.
At HBU, belief isn't just a mindset, it's an action. And our mission is to empower our students so their beliefs can fuel their lives. HBU, a higher education.
Lumberjacks make great teachers. Lumberjacks make great engineers, too. And urban foresters, composers, and CEOs. In fact, lumberjacks make great professionals in 120 fields of study. So no matter what you want to become, become an SFA lumberjack first.
Southland Conference Basketball on ESPN3, brought to you by Wild Wing Cafe, the official postgame headquarters of the Southland Conference Basketball Tournament. Katie's home for hot wings, cold beer, and good times.
Well, those Lumberjack fans, I don't know if they remember a year that SFA did not advance to the postseason, as this senior class went to the NIT in year one after falling to Northwestern State in the championship final. But the last 2 years, they were able to hold up as the number one seed all the way through and advance the NCAA tournament, looking to do it for a third straight year.
Well, we've got the 13th player of the day for Stephen F. Austin now on the floor. Jovan Grujic has just come into the ball game for the Lumberjacks.
Yeah, Grujic, a freshman out of Serbia, went to high school, though, up in Connecticut here in the States.
He's a good example of what Brad Underwood was talking about, makes him look better in the airport. He's 7 foot, 230 pounds.
You saw Odunsi taking a seat. And for Odunsi, your fingers are crossed that HBU will have a chance to play in a postseason tournament after the year that they have had, but it's certainly far from certain. He has certainly meant a lot to the rise of this program. And still not giving up. Again, it has been a fun 48 hours watching Asa Cantwell, the San Antonio native, shoot the basketball.
Well, he is indeed fun to watch. And I've said it before, he's got such a quick release.
Lumberjacks have been stuck on 99 points now for a while. Big man goes up. Robinson denies. Again, Isaiah Robinson has this one stripped away. And points 101, courtesy of Lasani Johnson, the Dallas native. And right now, we have the children of Clifford Robinson and Larry Johnson on the floor at the same time. It's like we're back in the 90s in the NBA.
Well, you're talking about two of the greats, and both of them many-time all-stars, and it is fun to watch their youngsters here in action. And how fitting, Lasani Johnson out of Bishop Dunn High School in Dallas, getting that 101 point, first time for the Lumberjacks over the century mark this year. And when he made it, it brought the biggest cheer of the day from the Lumberjack crowd.
Of Lasani's dad, a former UNLV national championship for Tark the Shark. And, of course, Robinson, native of Oregon, where his dad was an all-star in the NBA for the Trailblazers. He gets the rebound right here.
Stephen F. Austin staying in that zone defense. Looks like a little 1-2-2 that they're running right now. Houston Baptist firing away at will over it.
Cameron with the rebound. Thomas Walkup, it appears, will have played just 20 minutes in this ball game. and will be well rested for tomorrow's championship on ESPN2.
Yeah, 20 very outstanding minutes, 23 points, 6 rebounds, and 6 assists for the Conference Player of the Year.
Demetrius Floyd connected on 6 three-pointers, finished with 30 points on the day as well. Again, all that limited time, Floyd, 30 points in 21 minutes. And that shot needed a little bit more time. Shot clock expires. HBU already had the rebound. A 3-on-2 break. SFA will wisely slow it down.
Well, Lasani Johnson showing a little glimpse of his speed and quickness there, bringing the ball up the floor. Stephen F. continuing to set those picks on the post.
And just a tad too tall for Jaquan Smith, who wanted to bring the roof down.
Well, that was a good pass to Jaquan Smith. He should have just grabbed it with two hands instead of trying to do the tomahawk jump.
You and I can show him after the game.
Yeah. You're the one doing the talking, partner.
I say you and I. You can stand on my shoulders.
Yeah.
Inside the final minute, Cameron. Again, SFA has gone cold here as of late. The 112 points that McNeese State scored in this tournament back in 1983 appears to be safe for the most points in a tournament contest. That was against Louisiana Monroe. Cameron up ahead. And that's now the last 4 points for the Lumberjacks, coming from Lasani Johnson, the freshman.
Well, that was a nice drop-off by Dallas Cameron that time, and Lasani Johnson continuing to run the floor very well, being the beneficiary.
Cantwell. And SFA can dribble it out.
Now these two teams have combined for 16 three-point buckets, 9 by SFA. 6 of those 9 by Demetrius Floyd.
Brad Underwood is going to improve to 58-1 against Southland Conference opponents over the past 3 years. It won't mean a thing to him unless they can improve to 59-1 after tomorrow, with a berth into the NCAA tournament for a third straight year on the line. The number one seed advances 104-68 over the 4 seed out of nearby HBU.
Well, partner, anytime a team can score 104 points in a ball game and only have 5 turnovers, that means they are doing a lot of things right.
Meach Floyd connects on 6 three-pointers for 18 of his 30 points in just 21 minutes of play. And he is our Southland Strong player of the game in this semifinal.
Well, you know, he had to be something sensational to outdo teammate Thomas Walkup, who had the 23 points in 20 minutes. But you can see Meach Floyd. Watch his beautiful job on the threes. But what I like, when he has the ability to take the ball on the hardwood to the rack, he is so quick here, doing a nice assist to Walkup. Right back to Floyd. Great teamwork. That was the catalyst, getting SFA off to this great start here this afternoon.
And that completes this half of the bracket. Stephen F. Austin holds up strong as the number one seed. They will play either A&M Corpus Christi or perhaps for a third straight year, Sam Houston State in the final. We'll have that answer a little bit later on tonight when you rejoin us 7:30 Central Time here on ESPN3. For Jim Howler, I'm Lincoln Rose. A big thank you to our ESPN3 crew. Stephen F. Austin marches on to the final tomorrow on ESPN2.